Hi. Now we are going to see about Prim's spanning tree algorithm. This algorithm is used to find out the minimum cost spanning tree. Also, we are going to see one more algorithm which is called Kruskal's algorithm. This algorithm treats the nodes as the single tree and it keep on adding the new nodes to the spanning tree for the given graph. So now we will start this algorithm with some example so that we will understand this algorithm very clear. There are three steps. First step is we have to remove all the loops and parallel edges. If you look at the graph, this loop C is having cost of 1, which is going from C and it is going to C node itself. So we can remove this C node and parallel edges. If you look at the edge A to B, there are two edges. Sorry, if you look at the nodes A and B, two edges are there. One is having the cost of 6 and another one is having the cost of 9. So according to the step 1, we have to remove the loops and we have to remove the parallel edges as well. So we are going to remove the parallel edges from A to B, which is having the highest cost. So that is your first step, so which examines this diagram, which is given in dotted lines, that is going, that edges are going to be removed, because from C that one is going to C and from A to B the edge which is having the cost of 9, that is going to be removed because we have to choose that minimum cost. So we are going to choose the number of 6 over here. So we are going to remove this and we are going to remove this. You could not remove 6 because 6 is having less cost. That is your first step. Then now your graph is like this. Then your second step, choose any arbitrary node as the root node. So from this graph you are going to choose any of the node as the arbitrary node according to your wish to design the spanning tree using Prim's algorithm. So I am going to choose S as the root node. So we are going to create the spanning tree for that. Step 3 is check out the outgoing edges and select one with the less cost. So yes, we have chosen as a root node. From S node there are two edges which is called node A and node C. So this node A is having the cost of 7 and node C is having the cost of 8. The third step is we have to choose the less cost one, which is the outgoing from the root node. So we are going to choose 7 because this is having the less cost. So we are going to choose the path of S7A. So S2A we are going to choose because 8 is the biggest cost comparing to S2A. Then this route is chosen. Then again the same step we are going to repeat it. From A we are going to choose 3 or 6 which is less, that one we are going to choose. So from here we know that A to C is, this is less cost comparing to A to B. So we are choosing this path and then from C we are going to see the outgoing nodes. 8 is there, 4 is there, 3 is there. So obviously 3 is the minimal number. We are going to choose C to D. So this path we are going to choose. So this we have chosen from C to D we have chosen. Now we are going to see the edges which is coming out of the D. There are two edges B and T which is having the same cost. So D to T or D to B, you can choose any of the one from D. But the next step will be again yield the edge 2 as the least cost. So again you can choose either D to B or D to T, but both are having the same cost. The thing is, you next step is you have to choose any of this, and the next step will be the second node, which is the minimum cost. So first step you can choose D to B, and the second step will be D to T, and now all the vertices has been connected with both the edges included. So this is your final spanning tree algorithm using PRIMS. So next algorithm we can see in next video. In short, this algorithm we will see once again, only three steps. First step, you have to remove all the loops from the edges. Then second step, you have to choose any of the arbitrary node as a root node. Then third step, you have to check the outgoing edges and select the one with the less cost. You have to repeat these steps until you are just including all the vertices from this graph. With that, you are getting the final minimum cost spanning tree. With that, this PRIMS algorithm is getting over. Thank you. I will meet you with next video.